Hello everyone, welcome to the Lang Focus channel, and my name is Paul. How similar are Spanish and French? At this moment, you might be experiencing déjà vu. That comes from French, by the way.
Déjà vu.
What? Another romance language comparison? Hasn't he already compared Spanish and French? Nope. I've compared Spanish and Portuguese, Spanish and Italian, and French and Italian. But this is the first time that I've compared Spanish and French. So, let's look into it. Just like all Romance languages, Spanish and French both descended from varieties of Vulgar Latin. So even though they developed in different directions, they generally have a lot in common. But of course, there are lots of differences. The spoken languages are generally not mutually intelligible, but in writing, they are partially mutually intelligible. A lot of Lang Focus viewers have commented that they understand 60% or more of the other language in writing, but much less in speech. Vocabulary. The two languages have around 75% lexical similarity, meaning that 75% of the words in either language have cognates in the other language, cognates being equivalent words of the same etymological origin. Some of these cognates might be immediately recognizable, especially in writing.
Bien.
Bien.
Meaning fine or well.
Si.
Si.
Meaning if.
Content.
Contento.
Meaning happy.
Triste.
Triste.
Meaning sad.
Lent.
Lento.
Meaning slow.
Livre.
Libro.
Meaning book.
Bouteille de vin.
Botella de vino.
Meaning bottle of wine. Sometimes the differences are simple systematic differences. For example, words with this ending in French normally have this ending in Spanish.
Éducation.
Éducation.
Education.
Situation.
Situation.
Situation. Another example, PL in French often corresponds with double L in Spanish, the Y sound.
Pleuvoir.
Llover.
To rain.
Plein.
Lleno.
Full.
Pleurer.
Llorar.
To cry. Sometimes the cognates are a little less obvious or even hard to identify.
Œil.
Ojo.
Meaning eye.
Bouche.
Boca.
Meaning mouth.
Cou.
Cuello.
Meaning neck.
Cheval.
Caballo.
Meaning horse.
Cuillère.
Cuchara.
Meaning spoon. Of course, there are also plenty of false friends, words that you need to be careful of because they look or sound similar but actually have different meanings. Here are a few examples. In French,
large
means large. In Spanish,
largo
means long. In French,
nombre
means number. In Spanish,
nombre
means first name. In French,
salir
means to make something dirty. In Spanish,
salir
means to go out. In French,
bonbon
means a candy. In Spanish,
bonbon
means a chocolate. And here's another potentially embarrassing one. In French,
constipé
means constipated. And in Spanish,
constipado
means a cold, like you've caught a cold. So if someone asks you what's wrong, make sure you answer with the right word. In general, vocabulary is more different in everyday basic conversation. In French, the greeting, meaning good morning or good day, is
bonjour.
While in Spanish, it's
buenos días.
Bon
and
bueno
are cognates. And the words for day,
jour,
and
día
also have an etymological connection, but they now take very different forms. Another example, thank you very much. In French,
merci beaucoup.
In Spanish,
muchas gracias.
You can see that both words are different here. Can you speak more slowly?
Pouvez-vous parler plus lentement?
¿Puede hablar más despacio?
The verbs pouvoir and poder are cognates that trace back to Vulgar Latin potere, but have taken quite different forms. Also, the pronoun meaning you is absent from the Spanish sentence. And also, the verbs meaning speak are not cognates, and neither are the words meaning more and slowly. But there is another Spanish word meaning slowly, which is cognate.
Lentamente.
It's used with a slightly different nuance, like slowly and carefully, so it doesn't really fit this sentence. This is a good example of how cognates may exist in either language, but with different usage, or one word may be used more in one language than in the other. Pronunciation. Despite the fact that Spanish and French often use similar vocabulary, the words are usually pronounced quite differently. Recall these two words we saw before.
Triste.
And
triste.
Notice that the letter R represents two very different sounds in either word. In French, it's a guttural sound that's articulated at the back of the vocal tract, usually with a uvular fricative, ra. In Spanish, it's an alveolar tap that's articulated near the front of the vocal tract.
Triste.
Triste.
Also notice that the French word ends in a consonant sound, t, despite the written word ending in an e, while the Spanish word ends in a vowel sound, e. Also recall the words we saw meaning happy.
Content.
And
contento.
Again, we saw that the Spanish word ends in a vowel, as most Spanish words do, while the French word ends in a T in writing, but when spoken, it ends with a nasal vowel.
Content.
The final T is silent, like most final consonants in French, the exceptions being the consonants in the word careful, C, R, F, and L. In contrast, the only silent consonant in Spanish is H, which is silent except when it's preceded by C, in which case together they have the sound CH, like CH do in English. Also, EN is pronounced as a nasal vowel, EN. French has four such nasal vowels, but some of those four nasal vowels can be represented in writing by multiple combinations of letters. French also has up to 13 oral vowel sounds represented by various graphemes, graphemes meaning letters or combinations of letters. Spanish, on the other hand, has only 5 vowels, and for the most part they are consistently spelled in the same way, so that if you see a written word, you'll know how to say it. In French, there are also 5 accent markings, one for the consonant C, to indicate the soft pronunciation S, and the others are used with vowels, often to indicate a distinction in vowel sound. Spanish has only 3 accent markings. One main thing to be aware of is that the acute accent in French indicates the quality of the letter E, E rather than E, while in Spanish, this accent is just used in some words to show stress, or to distinguish between 2 words that otherwise look and sound the same. One other quirk of Spanish orthography that doesn't appear in French, or most other languages, is the use of an inverted question mark at the beginning of a question, in addition to the normal question mark at the end. For example,
¿De dónde eres?
Meaning, where are you from? There's also an inverted exclamation mark for exclamations.
Vete.
Meaning, go away. I think it makes sense, because exclamations and questions have different intonation and stress than simple statements, so it's better to know before the sentence begins so you can produce the right intonation and stress from the start. Grammar. In terms of grammar, Spanish and French are in large part quite similar, but of course not entirely. Spanish is pro-drop, which means that the subject pronouns are normally not necessary and can be dropped. We saw an example of this before.
Pouvez-vous parler plus lentement?
¿Puede hablar más despacio?
Notice that the second person singular subject pronoun doesn't appear in the Spanish sentence. Here's another example meaning he lives in Spain.
Il habite en España.
Vive en España.
Again, the third person singular pronoun is absent from the Spanish sentence, but it could be included for clarity, since without it, the subject of the sentence could be either male or female. And while we're at it with these two sentences, let's look at another difference, the verb meaning to live. In French, there's a different verb,
vivre,
which is a cognate of the Spanish verb
vivir.
It's used more generally with the meaning of to live, and the verb
habite
is used with the meaning of to live in a place or reside. The third person singular form of vivre,
vie,
would be correct in this sentence. But hold on, we were talking about word order. Another difference in syntax is that in Spanish, object pronouns can be attached to the end of present participles, infinitives, and imperatives, while in French, this is not possible. For example,
je veux l'acheter.
Lo quiero comprar. Quiero comprarlo.
To begin with, we see that the French and Spanish sentences have the object pronoun in a different place when there's an infinitive. In French, it's after the conjugated verb, while in Spanish, it's before the conjugated verb. But then in Spanish, it can optionally be placed at the end of the infinitive.
Quiero comprarlo.
There's nothing like that in French. Gender. All French and Spanish nouns are either masculine or feminine. For example, the white cat, in French,
le chat blanc,
and in Spanish,
el gato blanco.
These words, which are cognates, are both masculine. The white cow,
la vache blanche,
la vaca blanca.
These words, which are also cognates, are both feminine. You can see that the definite article, like the in English, also agrees with the gender of the noun, and so do adjectives. In French, this is almost always the case, but in Spanish, some adjectives have the same form for both masculine and feminine. Specifically, adjectives ending in e, and most adjectives ending in a consonant. In most cases, when the equivalent words are cognates, they have the same gender in both languages. There are a few exceptions, like
le serpent,
la serpiente,
meaning the snake, Words like these may cause some confusion for a speaker of one language learning the other, but a more common problem is that non-cognate nouns with the same meaning sometimes have different gender. For example, the bed,
le lit,
la cama,
the car,
la voiture,
el coche.
Notice the forms of the articles in French and Spanish. In French, the plural articles have just one form, while in Spanish, there are separate plural masculine and feminine articles. Pronouns. French and Spanish have both informal and formal second-person pronouns. In French,
tu
is the singular informal pronoun meaning you,
vous
is the formal singular or the plural pronoun. Similarly, in Spanish,
tu
is the singular informal form. And in some regional varieties, there's an alternate pronoun,
vos,
which is actually a cognate of the French pronoun vous, while the formal pronoun is
usted
in the singular. In Spanish, the informal formal distinction also appears in the plural. The informal plural form is
vosotros, vosotras,
while the formal plural form is
ustedes.
Also note that in Spanish, the formal pronouns are used with the third-person conjugation rather than the second-person conjugation. In French, this is not the case. Verbs. The general system of how verbs work is similar in French and Spanish. They both have 14 verb forms, which are often loosely called tenses, 7 simple tenses and 7 compound tenses, as well as the imperative form. Of course, the exact forms of the conjugations are different between the two languages, and there are a number of other differences as well. One difference is that French has just one verb meaning to be, être, while Spanish has two.
Ser, estar.
Ser is used to refer to inherent states of being, in other words, to describe what something is or who someone is. And estar is used for temporary or non-inherent conditions. This gets a little bit complicated sometimes, but I'll just give one simple example. She is a good person. In French,
c'est une bonne personne.
In Spanish,
ella es una buena persona.
Es is the third person singular of ser. She's in a good mood today.
Elle est de bonne humeur aujourd'hui.
Ella está de muy buen humor.
Está is the third-person singular form of estar. Another difference lies in the way past tense is expressed. Both French and Spanish have a simple past conjugation, passé simple in French, and pretérito in Spanish. They also both have an equivalent of the present perfect tense in English, passé composé in French, and the
pretérito perfecto compuesto
in Spanish. But in French, the passé simple has fallen out of use in the spoken language, so the passé composé is the basic way to express the past tense. In Spanish, the pretérito, the equivalent of the passé simple in French, is still widely used in the spoken language. For example, he drank a bottle of wine.
Il a bu une bouteille de vin.
Él bebió una botella de vino.
In the French sentence, we see the passé composé with the auxiliary verb avoir and the past participle bu, while in the Spanish sentence, we see the pretérito. In terms of form, the Spanish equivalent of the French sentence would be
él ha bebido una botella de vino.
But it means he has drunk a bottle of wine, rather than he drank. In Spanish, the present perfect form, along with all other compound tenses, always uses the auxiliary verb
haber.
But in French, there are two possible auxiliary verbs, avoir, a cognate of haber, which means have, or être, which means to be. All reflexive verbs use être. In addition to those, there are only 17 other verbs that use être, but they are very common verbs, which mainly refer to change of location or condition. For example, in French,
il est entré,
meaning he came in, or he has come in. And in Spanish,
él ha entrado,
meaning he has come in. In French, the auxiliary verb is être, while in Spanish it's haber, as always. In both sentences, the auxiliary verb is followed by the past participle, just like in English. In Spanish, the past participle stays the same, regardless of the subject. But in French, the past participle must agree with the subject. Let's check that by making the subject feminine.
Elle est entrée.
Ella ha entrado.
Notice that entrée becomes entrée with an extra e at the end, which indicates agreement with the feminine subject. Now let's make the subject plural.
Elles sont entrées.
Ellas han entrado.
In the French sentence, notice the S that indicates agreement with the plural subject, while in Spanish, the word stays the same. This is normally true for French verbs that use être. For French verbs that use avoir, it's a little different. Specifically, the past participle must agree with direct objects, rather than the subject, if the direct object comes before the verb. Before we saw these sentences.
Il a bu une bouteille de vin.
Él ha bebido una botella de vino.
He drank a bottle of wine. Let's replace the direct object with a pronoun.
Il l'a bu.
Él la ha bebido.
The noun meaning bottle is feminine in both languages, and in French, the past participle agrees with the feminine noun, but not the Spanish one. Also, remember the difference in the way past tense is expressed. Here I used the same present perfect construction for both French and Spanish, but remember that in French this would likely mean he drank it, while in Spanish it would have to mean he has drunk it, showing a connection to the current moment. Another difference in verbs is that Spanish has a present progressive form, similar to the one in English, while French doesn't. In Spanish, you conjugate the verb
estar,
which is followed by the present participle of the main verb. For example, to say I am eating, you would say
estoy comiendo.
In French, there's no such form. Instead, you would say
je suis en train de manger,
which means I'm in the process of eating. One more difference between French verbs and Spanish verbs is that conjugations in the subjunctive mood are used more in Spanish. The subjunctive shows some kind of subjectivity or unreality, and is normally used with certain verbs and after certain conjunctions, notably que or que. For example, I want you to do the work. In French,
je veux que tu fasses le travail.
In Spanish,
quiero que tú hagas el trabajo.
Both sentences use the present subjunctive of a verb meaning to do, faire in French, and
hacer
in Spanish, to show that the action is not a definite fact but a desire. But this is not always applied to the same verbs in either language. For example, the sentence meaning I hope that you do the work.
J'espère que tu fais le travail.
Espero que hagas el trabajo.
This time, in French, the indicative form is used, while in Spanish, the subjunctive is used. There are numerous cases like this. Those sentences use the present subjunctive. Both languages also have a past subjunctive, which is commonly used. Spanish also makes use of the imperfect subjunctive and the pluperfect subjunctive. In French, these subjunctive forms are literary forms that are reserved for formal writing. For example, the sentence meaning, I wanted him to do it. In Spanish,
quería que lo hiciera él.
And in French,
je voulais qu'il le fasse.
In both sentences, the main clause, on the left, uses the imperfect conjugation, showing an ongoing or incomplete action in the past. But in the Spanish sentence, this verb appears in the imperfect subjunctive form, while in French, the present subjunctive form is used. Technically speaking,
je voulais qu'il le fît
would be a correct sentence using the French imperfect subjunctive, but that is strictly a literary form, and people would probably think you sound kind of strange saying it. Okay, now that we've looked at some similarities and differences between the two languages, let's look at a couple of final sentences and see what we find. The following sentences mean she stayed at home last night because she didn't want to be tired today. In French,
elle est restée à la maison hier soir parce qu'elle ne voulait pas être fatiguée aujourd'hui.
Word for word, it's she stayed at the house yesterday evening because she negative wanted negative be tired today. And in Spanish,
ella se quedó en casa anoche porque ella no quería estar cansada hoy.
Word for word, it's she, reflexive particle, stayed in house last night because she, optional, negative, wanted be tired today. Right away, we can spot a number of similarities between these two sentences. The pronouns meaning she are similar, but remember that in Spanish, it's optional. The word meaning because is similar, and the verbs meaning to be are similar. But there are lots of differences, too. First, the French sentence uses the passé composé, whereas the Spanish sentence uses the simple past, the pretérito. And notice the word se that comes before the Spanish verb. This is a reflexive pronoun. The Spanish verb is a reflexive verb, meaning that the doer of the action is also the recipient of the action. Next, we see different prepositions showing location. In French, it's at the house, whereas in Spanish, it's in house. The French way of saying last night is
hier soir,
meaning yesterday evening, while Spanish uses a standalone word meaning last night. Again, notice that the subject pronoun is optional. Next, we can see a difference in negation between French and Spanish. In French, the particle ne precedes the verb, and the particle pas comes after. And in everyday speech, ne is usually dropped. In Spanish, the negation particle is no. Next, these verbs are different in either language, but both are in the imperfect conjugation, showing an ongoing action at a point in the past. Next, the words for tired are different, and the words for today are different. But actually, this little part right here, oui, is a cognate of hoy.
Aujourd'hui
equals au jour de oui, on the day of today. Oui and hoy both come from Latin
odier.
As you can see, French and Spanish have a lot in common, and a speaker of one language will benefit from a lot of those similarities when learning the other language. But with that said, they're also full of differences, both major and minor. Sometimes you might see sentences that look really similar, and other times you might see sentences that look almost completely different. I guess that's to be expected when you consider that they both share a common root in vulgar Latin dialects, but have been diverging for well over 1,000 years. The question of the day. For native speakers of either language, how similar are they to you? To what extent are you able to understand the other in speech and in writing? And to other people, how similar do they seem to you? Does it seem like knowing one of them would make it easier to learn the other? If you enjoyed this video, be sure to check out the different LangFocus social media accounts like Facebook, YouTube, Twitter, and Instagram. And as always, I want to say a special thanks to all of my Patreon supporters, especially my top-tier Patreon supporters, whose names appear right here on the screen. Many extra special thanks to them. And to everyone, thank you for watching and have a nice day.